Question. For the truss shown in the figure, find the force in the member QR. Here we are using method of section for the calculation of member force QR. Method of section. As a next step, let's cut a section which includes the, which also cut the member QR. So this is the section I am choosing, and I name that XX, which cut member QR, member RT and member ST. And all the cut members cutted, the force in these members will be treated as tensile. This is only our assumption. It may be changed after the calculation. So let's consider all the members have tensile force. Now we are considering the equilibrium of portion right side of the cut. And we are taking moment with respect to T. That means with respect to T, the moment, sum of moment will be 0 under equilibrium. Sigma MT equal to 0. So equilibrium equation. So we know that member force TR and TS passing through the point T, so these forces won't be considered because they are passing through the point T, so the moment becomes 0. So only forces left are member force QR and the external force P. So let's consider the clockwise moment as positive. Clockwise is positive. So P into that lever arm will be L. It's already given in the question. So P into L minus, because the member force QR is taken as tensile and it is in the, it make an anti-clockwise moment with respect to point T, and its lever arm will be L. So we get FQR, FQR is the force in the member QR, multiplied by its lever arm L, which is equal to 0. From this very simple equation, we get FQR equal to P. And our assumption is correct because we get a positive value. So it is tensile force. So the answer is option C, P. Question. Carryover factor CAB for the beam shown in the figure given below is. First of all, we need to understand what is carryover factor. Carryover factor COF is equal to carryover moment COM divided by the applied moment. Applied moment. Then what is carryover moment? Carryover moment, which is carried to the far end of a beam or any member, when we are applying a moment to the near end. So here we want to find the carryover factor CAB. That means near end is A and far end is B. So I am going to apply a clockwise moment. Clockwise moment M at point A, and what will be the moment generated at point B, that we need to find as a first step, MB. For that, we know that this is an internal hinge. This is internal hinge. So with respect to internal hinge, I am going to name this hinge point as C. The bending moment with respect to C is 0. That is, MC is going to be 0. So if we apply a force, moment M, there will be a reaction developed here, and I am giving that reaction in the upward direction as VA. So as a first step, let's calculate the value of VA. by taking bending moment with respect to point C is 0. And we are considering clockwise moment positive. So VA into its lever arm is L, and also the applied moment also in clockwise direction, so it's also positive, which is equal to 0. From here we get VA equal to minus M divided by L. So our assumption is wrong, that is we are assumed the direction of VA as upward, in actual it is in the downward direction, but we are not changing the figure, so we are treating VA is minus L. Let's take this as equation number 1. And next we need to find the MB. So we know that there is no external forces here, so here we are considering another vertical reaction VB. Since there is no vertical forces, external forces, so VA plus VB equal to 0, or VA is minus M by L plus VB equal to 0, which implies VB equal to M by L. This is VB, and I am taking this as equation number 2. So here the direction of VB, as we assumed, it is in the upward direction, so we get a positive value. Next we need to find the value of MB. For finding MB, we can take the bending moment with respect to C will be 0, because it is internal hinge, and the definition of bending moment is sum of moments towards right or left of the section will be 0. So this moment is positive, MB is in the clockwise direction we are assumed, so MB minus, because VB into its lever arm, that moment will be in the anti-clockwise direction, so minus VB into its lever arm L is equal to 0. So MB equal to VB into L, that is VB is M by L multiplied by L, that is equal to M, which is clockwise. So our assumption is, which is positive value, and our assumption is correct. So we get value of MB is M, which is clockwise. Similarly, the applied moment which is equal to M, this also clockwise. So the carryover factor is equal to the carryover moment MB divided by the applied moment M, which is equal to M divided by M, which is equal to 1. So the carryover factor is 1 and the carryover moment is M. So the answer is carryover factor, and the value option D is correct.